You're here because you're looking for a portable solar panel that you can use with your EcoFlow solar generator. Or you have a different solar generator and you really like the look of the EcoFlow panels. Hello, I'm Wanderer001 and this is my review of the EcoFlow 110W solar portable panel. Now, I do really like the fact that EcoFlow for their panels actually gives you this carrying case right here. So the panel itself is actually built into this. You are looking at a closed case that is 21 inches wide and 17 inches tall. Now that is a four panel set that gets compacted into this portable size. Now the exterior of this is actually kind of like a cloth fabric. You've got a nice big EcoFlow logo right there. And it has a carrying handle, which is kind of like a synthetic leather feel right up here. It does Velcro into place so that you can keep both handles together. One of the things that I really like about the EcoFlow carrying case here, or the panels themselves, is if you look right there, the zipper actually is kind of like webbed together and it creates a seal around the zipper itself so that you don't have any water leaking in. Now, the one thing I kind of wish they did a little better with the case here is that only one side of the case is stiff, meaning that there's something in here that protects the solar panel. If we flip it over to the other side, there's actually nothing here protecting the internal solar panel. And if we come and we unzip our panel, so we'll just spin this around and it comes over like that. You can kind of see what we're looking at here. We'll flip that open. And this is what I was referring to in that one side of the panel is flexible. You have these, what I call carabiner clips, kind of built into it so that you can set up your panel. Now I'm going to flop that over. And then here we have more branding. You can see this is the backside of the panel. This is not the actual solar cell itself. Right there, it lets you know that this is a monocrystalline silicone cell inside. And if I flip over my solar panel here, here's the other side. EcoFlow lets you know it's the 110W solar panel. Here you have your converter, and then it just has these MC4 hookups. So I just left the actual cable that came with my River Pro attached, since I will always be using these. And again, you see there's grommets, and then you have more carabiner clips. If I flop this open here, you get a good look at the solar cell right here. Now, this actually has a rubberized coating on it, so you don't have to worry about damaging the actual panel itself. You're gonna have dust resistance, you're gonna have water resistance. In fact, the panel itself is IP67 rated and has four sections to it. Now, I have it on top of a table. Make a little more sense once we get this kind of installed so you get an idea of what we're looking at. Here you can see the solar panel folded out and you have your four separate sections here. And when it's completely open like this, you're looking at 62.5 by 20 inches with a depth of just shy of 1/2 inch. Now, the entire weight of this, including the carrying case for it, is only 5 pounds. So this is a super portable device and very useful for charging up your EcoFlow or other power stations. Now keep in mind that it does have a 22 to 20% efficiency rating. And what that means is as you take energy in from the sun, it does need to be converted into an electrical current that can be used by your solar generator. So you have a 22 to 20% efficiency for that conversion, which is pretty good when compared to other models. Now, one of the things that I don't particularly care about with the EcoFlow here, and you can kind of see it right up here for the top, like I said, that part of the case actually has a hard stand so that you can kind of prop it up. Underneath there, that's just flopping around. I don't really like the fact that you don't have two hard stands to work with. Also, you'll see it's kind of flopping on the wings there. And when I take you to the back of it, you'll see why. It's just supported in the middle. It really needs like a little flap out wing on either side to kind of help keep things pointed in the direction that you want. But that's not terrible. You can find ways of doing that. In fact, when I use my River Pro with this, I put it behind one of the panels to one, keep it out of the sun, but two, also help prop it up. I mentioned that it does have these metal grommets that allow you to kind of place it as you need. And again, if you don't want to use the stand, you don't have to. And here's an example I was referring to with the back. You can kind of tilt these as you want, but they're going to flop on either side. Again, it does give you a lot of variable as to how you can place it, but if you're trying to get peak sun and you're trying to tilt this, you're gonna deal with those droopy wings. So just something to consider. Now, I have used this pre-spring on a partly cloudy day. Today is definitely not the optimal time for this, but when I did charge my EcoFlow battery with this, I had a 1 to roughly 85% charge in about 7 hours of charge time, which again, spring, not super sunny, that's what I was getting. I had a maximum charge watt of about 96 watts, and I'll flash some stuff up on the screen here so you can see. So again, not peak sun usage, but pretty good, all things considered. Now, I'll bring over my River Pro, plop it up behind here so you can kind of see what things look like.
All right, so this will be charging from solar panels. It's a spring day, not a summer day, and partially cloudy. These are the 110 watt solar panels. I'll be coming out to move them around to keep up with the sun. I have the EcoFlow sitting on a cardboard box because I didn't want to put it in the grass. And I also am using it to prop up the solar panels to keep them properly aligned. So now we're up to like 92 input, which is pretty good. Showing 7 hours, and I loaned this to a neighbor to test out so they could see if they wanted one for themselves, and they kind of got it down to 1%. So if you don't get it down that low, it shouldn't take 7 hours. But here's my current setup. Have them pointed in the general direction of the sun. Like I said, I'll be moving them around as the sun moves across my sky. I'll set up a time lapse so you can watch me fiddling with these over the time to catch the best sun. Kind of there's the front angle of what the sun looks like. And like I said, we're looking at 7 hours. As long as the wind doesn't blow this down, I might attach a bungee, kind of keep this up. Time will tell. But roughly 7 hours from zero, or one. So we'll find out how that does. So here we are at the end of the day. Pretty much getting like zero sunlight now. Let's see what we got. So we're at 85% and we're pulling in 3 watts of power. So this says it'll take 46 hours to actually charge with only 3 watts. Not bad. So we got about 84%. We had a high of 90-ish watts in and an average probably about 70 all day. So that's not terrible, all things considered, from the 110 watt solar panels.
Now, while the solar panel does use the standard MC4 connectors, meaning you can use this with other brands other than just EcoFlow, if you happen to use your EcoFlow solar panel here with an EcoFlow product, you will get to take advantage of what they're calling MPPT, which is maximum power point tracking. What this will do is automatically adjust the flow coming into your EcoFlow product so that it has a constant power supply, meaning very little fluctuation. So that's a plus if you're using this with an EcoFlow solar generator. Now, one of the big things to consider with a solar panel, whether it's portable or not, is pricing. And I will say that the EcoFlow solar panels are a little on the pricier side, but for the weight, portability, and solar conversion that you're actually getting with it, I'm really happy I picked it up, especially if you're picking up an EcoFlow solar generator. You're gonna wanna pick one of these up anyway. And that first time that you plug in your solar generator and get a good day of sun and charge it up using a solar panel like this, you're gonna realize why you picked it up. You don't wanna just charge it off the grid, you wanna charge it off grid or in a, hey, the grid's down type of situation. So in those cases, something like this is immensely useful, and I am really happy that I picked it up. And I would recommend, if you have an EcoFlow solar generator yourself, you're probably going to want to look into this one or some of the big brother versions that have more wattage than the 110 watt. 110 watts a great place to start, but they have other models that are similar construction, larger panels. So because of that, highly recommend the 110 watt EcoFlow solar panels. With that being said, I have been Wanderer 001. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the area below. And as always, thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a like, as that will help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here, you can always help fuel the next review by buying me a coffee, link in the description below. Last but not least, if you want to be notified when I upload a new video, you know what to do.